Hi friends, we'll solve problem on D'Alembert's principle. Just see what is given in problem. The 350 Newton box rests on horizontal for which coefficient of kinetic friction is mu k equal to 0.32. If the box is subjected to a 400 Newton towing force as shown, find the velocity of box in 4 seconds starting from rest. That means in this case what is given, this block is having some weight equal to 350 Newton. Towing force means what? Pull type of force is acting, inclination is 30 degree. If the box is subjected to a force of 400 Newton, find the velocity of box in 4 seconds starting from rest. That means initial velocity is 0. After 4 seconds you have to find out velocity. We'll find out acceleration of box. Once we'll get acceleration of this box using equations of kinematics, we'll find out its velocity. Let me, first step is what? Initial velocity is what? 0. You have to find out what? Final velocity at t equal to 4 seconds. Therefore, using this equation, v equal to u plus a into t. That means velocity equal to u0, acceleration into 4. That means velocity equal to 4a. That means what you have to do now? Simply find out acceleration of block applying D'Alembert's principle. To find out acceleration of this block, I will draw free body diagram. In FBD, weight 350 Newton given, 400 Newton towing force, mu is what? 0.32. I will draw FBD just on next page, just here. FBD of box. Now this one box is initially at rest. Say this one is your reference line. Now which forces acts here? Weight of this box. Weight of box is given. How much is the weight of box? 350 Newton. What external force is acting here is nothing but 400 Newton inclined at an angle of 30 degrees with horizontal. Then normal reaction acts on the block. Normal reaction acts normal to the contact surface. That means in upward direction. This is what? Rn. Now due to this 400 Newton, definitely body or box will accelerate in rightward direction. Frictional force will get in leftward direction. Mu is given as a 0.32, so this is 0.32 Rn. This is nothing but free body diagram. Important force, what is remaining now? That is inertia force, which acts in opposite direction of acceleration. Acceleration due to 350 Newton, you will get in rightward direction. Therefore, in opposite direction of acceleration, I will add here MA force, means what? Inertia force. Now to find out this acceleration, first we will find out Rn here. To find out Rn, we will apply equation along y-axis, summation of Fy equal to 0, assuming upward force is positive. Now what forces are acting here? First one is Rn. Next, component of this 400 is what? 400. Sine 30 minus this is what? 350 equal to what? 0. That means normal reaction comes out to be 350 minus 400 sine 30. That means this answer comes out to be what? 150 Newton. Now we'll apply D'Alembert's principle in horizontal direction. That means if you'll apply equation along x-axis, to what will get here? Summation of fx equal to 0, assuming rightward force is positive. Now which includes inertia forces, therefore what will get here? Component of 400 rightward plus 400 cos 30, frictional force minus 0.32 into Rn, inertia force again m into a equal to 0. Only three forces, component of 400, then frictional force and MA. Now this one is 400 cos 30, minus 0.32, Rn is 150, minus mass of box is not given, weight is given, therefore mass, if you want to find out, I will take this weight divided by g, means 9.81 into acceleration. Unknown term is only acceleration. Using calculator, if you calculate, A comes out to be 8.364 meters per second square. Using this acceleration, if you find out what is the velocity, that v you have written as what, u plus at, where u is 0 and a into t, that means 4 times a, which is equal to 4 into 8.364 meter per second square. That means what is the velocity of box is 33.45 meters per second. This is nothing but final answer of this problem. Thank you.